Hi, this is Kavita Saini and I am a legal intern of LEXIS AND COMPANY and I am a law student of IME Law College. And today we are going to discuss about a new topic, which is Article 17 of Indian Constitution. Article 17 of Indian Constitution talks about the untouchability, and untouchability is abolished and its practice in any form is forbidden. The enforcement of any disability arising out of untouchability shall be an offence punishable in accordance with law. On the ground of untouchability, no person can be denied access to shops, public restaurants, hotels, places of public entertainment, or the use of walls, ponds, lakes and bathing ghats and roads and places to public resort and maintained wholly or partly by the state funds or dedicated to the use of general public. Untouchability is neither defined in the Indian Constitution and in any act. It refers to a social practice which looks down upon certain depressed classes on account their birth and make discrimination against them on his ground, and their physical touch was considered to be a polluted, and such castes which were considered as untouchables were not allowed to draw water from the wells, ponds, lake which used by the higher caste people. They were not allowed to enter some temples and suffered from many disabilities. Inclusion of this provision in the Constitution shows the importance attached by the Constituent Assembly towards eradication of this evil practice. Article 17 is also a significant provision from the point of view of equality before law. It guarantees social justice and dignity of a man, the twin privileges which were denied to a vast section of the Indian society for centuries together. Article 35 with Article 17 confer on the Parliament power to make laws protecting punishment or prescribing and practicing untouchability. The Parliament enacted the Untouchability Offence Act of 1955. In 1976, it was made more stringent and was renamed and the Protection of Civil Rights Act 1955. It defines civil rights and as any right acquired to a person by reason of the abolition of untouchability by Article 17 of the Constitution. All offences under the Act have been made non-compoundable, and the Act prescribed punishment up to 1 to 2 year imprisonment and for preventing any person from entering any place of public worship or from worshipping, or denying access to any shop, public restaurant, hotels or places of public entertainment, or refusing to admit person to hospital and refusing to sell goods or services to any person, also insulting a member of scheduled caste on the ground of untouchability, or preaching untouchability, or justifying it on a historical, philosophical, religious or other ground, it considered as a crime. To prevent the commission of offences or atrocities against the member of the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, the Parliament also enacted the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe Prevention of Atrocities Act of 1989. The Act provides for special courts for trial of offences under the Act and for the relief and rehabilitation of the victim of such offence. Atrocities committed against a Hindu SC and STs who had converted to another religion and can be prosecuted under the Act. In state of Karnataka versus Appabalu Ingle, the Supreme Court, expressing its concern on the continuance of the practice of untouchability, held it was an indirect form of slavery and only extension of caste system. So that's all for today. I hope you guys like this video and learn something from it. And so do like, share and comment and subscribe the channel. Thank you.